I think we are live. I'll start the lesson then. Thank you, Nikhil. I just checked. I think we are live. Great. Okay, so sorry everyone for getting late in today's session. Do we have anybody joining or attending today's class? Please participate in the comment section. Okay, so this is first lesson or first class of the series called as Education Abroad. So where I am going to discuss more about what, when, how and where of GRE and GMAT examinations. And without any further ado, let's get started. I believe we are already a little bit late to start our session today. So I don't know if anyone's attending. Is anybody here for today's lesson? Okay, so let's get started. What we had today. So this is a series called as Education Abroad, where I'm going to cover many different aspects and topics of education abroad. And what you will get in the this series is the what exams are best for you, and which how to prepare the documents like statement of purpose, letters of recommendation, and also how to shortlist universities, how to apply for scholarships. Okay, all these, I won't say little, but these are very many important aspects of your overall abroad journey, which are very important in the long run. So let's see what we can get it covered here. So first about me, who am I? So my name is Anu. I work and live in US. I have my master's in statistics from US and I work as a scientist. I work as a research scientist here. Then I have been teaching, mentoring for last 15 years in the education and abroad migration field. And these are my GRE scores. My GRE score was AWA was 5 out of 6, verbal 162, quantitative 158. Then next is on Unacademy, I am providing many types of courses with respect to IELTS and also with the abroad migration, such as such as how to apply for jobs abroad, how to prepare your resume, how to prepare for interviews, all these things. So you can use my code ANUWHAT to sign up the Unacademy Plus subscription and get a 10% discount on the subscription. Okay, so you find many courses on an academy platform, and I am teaching a writing course, IELTS writing course. I'm teaching reading course. I'm teaching speaking course. I'm teaching vocabulary course. The next is, why take GRE or GMAT? GRE and GMAT. Why take these exams? The big question students have, like, why? That's the whole thing, like, why? So, GRE exams or GRE test is required for applications by most graduate schools and a few number of business schools. So, most graduate schools means many schools that offer courses such as masters in science, like MS, different types of MSs, and a few business schools, like a few schools that offer MBA degrees or management degrees, they accept GRE scores. So both are valid and you can use both. That's fine. And for GMAT, GMAT scores are solely used for business schools and management schools all around the world. Then next is, what is the test structure? What is the test structure for GRE and GMAT? What's the difference between the test structure of these two tests? So first is, for GRE, there you are given 60 minutes for analytical writing. Okay, so you are given 60 minutes for analytical writing. And you, in 60 minutes, you got to write two essays, 30 minutes each. That is most important. Then in GMAT, you get 30 minutes to write one AWA section of essay, one essay in 30 minutes, which is possible, which is very easy and absolutely possible if you practice properly. Then in GRE, two sections, 30 minutes each for verbal. And in GMAT, 30 minutes for integrated reasoning section. Then in GRE, two 35-minute quantitative reasoning section. And in GMAT, 62 minutes of quantitative section. In GRE, there is also a surprise section, either verbal or quant, depends. It could be 30 minutes or 35 minutes, depending on what section it is. In GMAT, 65 minutes of verbal section is there. GRE is a computer adaptive test by section, and paper version is offered in very few places, like literally like one or two places in the world where you can take paper GRE. Then computer adaptive test is GMAT. That means the level becomes difficult with every correct answer you give in the exam. Coming on next, that is scoring system. What is the scoring system of GRE and GMAT? That is, each point, each section is 170 points. That is, verbal is 170 points and quants is 170 points. Total points in GRE exam are 340. So you will see people saying their scores that are out of 340. Okay. Analytical writing section is scored out of six total points. 4 and above score is considered a good score for AWA. Plus, the cost of GRE is $205. Whereas in GMAT, the score ranges from 200 to 800 points. The scores increases in the 10 points increments. And the score above 650 is considered good or acceptable. Okay, it could be good or acceptable to apply into the business schools, unless any university or any school gives you a cutoff that is mentioned in the school. If they tell you a cutoff, if they tell like they need minimum score of 700, then you know you need 700 minimum score. If you have less than 700, then there's a great chance that your application to such a school might get rejected. Just be prepared and do your research properly. The next is the GMAT is 250 in cost of the test. Then moving on, again, I want to repeat my referral code, that is Anu Watt. where you can get 10% discount on Unacademy Plus. Use this code to join me on Unacademy, and you can get all the help needed for all types of your abroad questions. So please join. The next is, what is easier? Many students ask me, you know, like, what is easier? Which is easier? Is it GRE that's easier, or is it GMAT? Well, it depends. I can't answer for you, right? I don't know exactly what you are looking for. I don't know exactly what you need. So I can't answer. But however, I really need to, I would share with you here that what are the sections which are usually easier in both the examinations, and which sections are difficult. So in GRE, quantitative section is straightforward. If your maths basics are clear, if your concepts are clear, you're good. You can score good score in mathematics right away. And in verbal section of GRE is highly dependent on the strong vocabulary. So here I cannot emphasize enough how strong your vocabulary needs to be in order to get a good score in verbal section. In verbal section, your asset or your strong point is going to be the vocabulary. GRE vocabulary section is more challenging GRE verbal section is more challenging because of vocabulary. Okay. In GMAT, you need more quantitative and analytical skills because the questions in GMAT, the quantitative section in GMAT needs you to analyze from different perspectives. So it's not straightforward math. It's very applied math. So it's an applied maths, so you need to know exactly what they are asking and how you are going to reach your answer. That's one thing. Data interpretation section in quantitative is a complex to solve, of course, in GMAT, I agree. And this is where it makes it a very difficult computer adaptive test. So moving on, which scores MBA schools accept? 90% of business schools accept GMAT scores. However, there are few schools which accept GRE scores too. I think their number must be around like less than 5% right now. So there are schools that accept GRE scores. So make sure whichever school you choose, you know what exams they require. Almost 100% of graduate schools accept GRE scores. This is all the degrees other than management degrees or business school degrees. Okay, some graduate school may even waive off as in not require GRE scores at all for applications, but not always. So be very careful. Next. Should you take GRE or GMAT? Many students ask me these questions, like, what should we take? Should we take GRE or should we take GMAT? We don't know what to do. So it depends. Learn what university exam policies are. I mean, first of all, you know roughly which universities you need to apply. You know roughly. So be aware what their policies are, which exams they require, what's their cutoff, and what's the requirement for that university's application. That way you know that what you are going to do. Then next is, take practice tests. Take both practice tests, GRE practice test and GMAT practice test, and compare the scores for both tests. And see which one suits your preparation skills better. Okay. Do not give an exam because you have to give an exam. Give it because you need to for your applications. Okay. Because if you feel that even though you don't need an exam and you are still giving it, it's wasting of efforts, it's wasting of time and wasting of energy and money. So be very sure, be very prudent as to which exam you need to give, or whether or not you need to give exam in the first place. That's very important to know. Give an exam because you absolutely need to for your applications, not because you are just giving it. You give an exam because you know for a fact that you need that exam for your applications. Then here I'm going to say something about who can help you with your process. That is, always hire a mentor or a counselor who has been through, who has been in your shoes and who knows what you're going through. I have done my master's in US. It's tough migrating to a different country. It's very, very tough. For me, it was very tough. My journey was very excruciatingly difficult. Every day I had different problems and I was alone. Nobody was there to help me out in my issues and my problems. So I learned everything by myself. I was scared. I was very scared every step of the moment. And I thought that I am not going to go anywhere. I won't be able to go anywhere with my struggle. But still, I made it. And with my experience, with me, I am 100% sure I can help you in your admission process as well. So to know more about me and what I do and my courses on Unacademy, please feel free to join me using my code, that is Anu. What? Or code Anu. What? Remember this code. You get a 10% discount and you can join me. And I would be more than happy. I'd be actually glad to help you in your abroad admissions and your abroad journey. This is an opportunity with Unacademy. This is once in a lifetime opportunity with Unacademy that you can join me. I am nowhere else on the platform. I don't use Facebook. I don't use... hello, everyone. Welcome to our class. I see we have two more people in our class today. Thank you for joining. Hello. So I can help you with everything. So use my code and join me so that you get what you are looking for. I don't think any other, I have not seen any educator on Unacademy who has an education from abroad and who's sharing the knowledge of how to apply to abroad universities or whatever I'm covering here. They are sharing what they know about the examinations. But no one's on Unacademy is sharing about the process. Okay, the excruciating process of moving abroad. I hope everybody understands Hindi. So main yahan par ye kehna chah rahi thi ki jo bhi educator humne dekhe hain Unacademy par humne abhi, वो सारे educators I have उनमें से मैंने किसी को देखा नहीं है जिनके पास abroad degree है. Education hai, and that is where there's the difference lies. Wahi par pura fark samajh aata hai hume. So I can help you with everything here. So you need someone who understands you and to support you through the difficult process of abroad educations. Okay. You can join me, of course. You should join me. Actually, you must join me to join all structured live classes, lessons by top educators, weekly quizzes and doubt clearing sessions. Join me on Unacademy. My referral code is ANUWHAT, where you get a 10% discount on your plus subscription. Again, my referral code is ANUWHAT and you get a 10% discount on your subscription. This is all I had today in today's lesson, and I hope to see you all in my next YouTube session. Until then, I wish you all a very good day and have a nice time. Bye-bye.